Welcome to antenna and wave propagation playlist. Here in this session, I'll be going to explain basic parameters of radiation pattern. So when we have a radiation pattern of antenna, what are the basic parameters that we need to understand? That I'll be going to explain in this session. So here I will explain this radiation pattern by two ways. One is by having a radiation pattern by this radiation pattern, and then I'll explain that in plane how it happens. So here if I say I have an antenna which is radiating in XY plane, and its radiation pattern that is somewhat this. So this is the major lobe which is there with this radiation pattern, and these are side lobes. So I'll explain how this radiation pattern that happens with this axial mode of radiation pattern and how it is there with the circular mode of radiation pattern. So this is major lobe. These are side lobes. And this is back lobe. Now here, if you see this major lobe, so that is having radiation with respect to this angle, where one can say this is what x-axis, this is y-axis, and it is making angle 45 degree with respect to x-axis, and consider angle at y-axis is equals to 0 degree. So I have considered angle with respect to y-axis is 0 degree. And this is 45 degree angle with both of the side which is there with major lobe. So when I plot it with respect to this gain characteristic, so that is having major lobe over here at 0 degree. So here it is 0 degree, so here it is 0 degree over here, and at 45 degree means somewhere over here 45 plus and 45 minus it is having major lobe. So this will be a major lobe which is there with this radiation pattern. And then if you see is 90 degree, is minus 90 degree. So 90 and minus 90 degree. So up to this there is first side lobe. So this is what first side lobe, 90 and minus 90. It's like that. And then after, if you see, this is somewhat 150 degree, is minus 150 degree. So second side lobe that is there from 90 to 150 degree. So 150 degree is somewhere over here. So it is like this. And in 180 degree means this direction. So that is 180 degree. So minus 180 or 180, both are same. So that is having back lobe. So that is this. So this is how radiation pattern is there, where here this is major lobe. These are side lobes. And this is back lobe. So that is how radiation pattern is there. Now I'll explain few basic definitions which is required to understand radiation characteristics. So first basic definition, that is half power beamwidth. So if I say this is maximum gain, so 3 dB down, if I say this is 0 dB, so this is 3 dB. So this width which is associated with 3 dB down, so this angular width that is called as half power beam width. So let us write it first and let us try to understand how it is there. So H HPBW half power beam width. So it is a width of major lobe. It is a angular width of major lobe from max to 3 dB down. It is a width of major lobe from max to 3 dB down. So this is maximum gain. From below that 3 dB down, width of that major lobe is half power beam width. Now second is first null beam width. So major lobe is having first null over here and first null over here. So let us try to understand how first null beam width is there. So it is a width of major lobe, means it is a width of first null of major lobe. So this is first null beam width. Now what is the basic definition of it? First null beam width. It is a width of major lobe. It is a width of major lobe. So here first nulls are there for major lobe. So its width, angular width, that is what first null beam width. Now if you see half power beam width, then in this radiation pattern even one can measure it. This is maximum and 3 dB down is somewhere over here. So this is 3 dB gap, and if you see this, then this width, this angular width, so that will be half power beam width. And here if you see, nulls are there, first nulls are there for this major lobe. So this width, that is first null beam width. So that is how half power beam width and first null beam width is there. Now third major definition, that is front to back ratio. Front to back ratio. So front to back ratio is a ratio of gain of major lobe to back lobe. So it is a ratio of gain from major lobe to back lobe. So front to back ratio, that is a ratio of gain from major lobe to back lobe. So this is what a gain of major lobe, and this is what a gain of back lobe. So ratio of this major lobe gain divided by back lobe gain is front to back ratio. So that is how one can calculate all those basic parameters which is associated with radiation pattern. Let us have a quick review of this radiation pattern again. This is what directional antenna's radiation pattern that I have shown over here. It is having this major radiation in this lobe. So this is major lobe. These are side lobes and this is back lobe. Back lobe is a lobe which is exactly opposite to the major lobe. So this is major lobe, opposite to that is back lobe. So this is back lobe. And I have translated this radiation pattern in this way. So one can observe these two radiation pattern. Both are same. Ultimately, the way we represent that is having little difference. Otherwise, both are same. Now here half power beam width, that is a width, angular width of major lobe from maximum to 3 dB down. Half power beam width, that is angular width of major lobe from maximum to 3 dB down. First null beam width, that is a width of major lobe. One can see in both of the diagram. This is first null beam width, is half power beam width from 3 dB down. First null beam width, that is what width of nulls of major lobe. And front to back ratio, that is a ratio of gain of major lobe and back lobe. So ratio of this major lobe gain divided by back lobe gain is front to back ratio. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you have any query regarding this, you can place that in comments. And you can suggest me those videos which is required to complete antenna and wave propagation playlist. And here one can take a snapshot to make a notes. So I'm just giving you little time to take a snapshot of this radiation pattern, and these are the basic definitions of which you can take a snapshot. Thank you so much for watching this.